For the first time in weeks, we've had a clear indication of when we can finally travel north to Queensland. But it's a different story to the south. Victoria has responded to its growing number of COVID-19 infections and blatant refusal by its residents to be tested by locking down 36 suburbs.
The Sunshine State. Closed one day, open the next.
From July the 10th, people will be allowed to travel into Queensland after filling in a border declaration.
Our beach holidays up north are back on. Queensland's borders reopening to every state and territory, except one.
The border with Victoria will remain closed and will be strengthened.
Victorians will be turned away at the Queensland border, while residents of New South Wales will have to declare you haven't been to Victoria in the last fortnight before they let us in.
Our concern is people from New South Wales going into Victoria and then choosing to come to Queensland.
The outbreak in Melbourne continues to pick up speed. 64 new infections, more than 250 in the past 5 days. And they're going back into lockdown.
The challenge we face now is very much a public health bushfire.
Hundreds of thousands of people who live in 36 hotspot suburbs must stay at home for the next month. Like China did with Wuhan, those areas of Melbourne are now ring-fenced and people cannot travel in or out of them.
Police will be actively enforcing these suburban lockdowns.
During a blitz over the weekend, almost 1,000 people refused tests. The Premier admitting the source of the outbreak was security guards deployed to hotel quarantine and hopelessly compromising it.
Staff members in hotel quarantine breaching well-known and well-understood infection control protocols. That is unacceptable to me.
Even with just 5 new cases in Sydney, all of them returning travellers, Gladys Berejiklian is not considering closing our southern border.
We've demonstrated to date our capacity to leave our borders open and deal with the virus.
Premier Berejiklian comfortable with Melbourne locking suburbs down. That way, potential cases can't get here.
There will be outbreaks, there will be hotspots. And you can't just shut Australia up every time there's an outbreak.
Melbourne's lockdowns will have an immediate impact on Sydney. The Victorian Premier has asked the Prime Minister to redirect all international flights scheduled for the next 2 weeks into Melbourne. Now, it's our understanding that could be as many as a dozen flights, maybe many more, bringing back Australian citizens and residents home. Now, the lion's share of those flights will be taken by Sydney, and that means more work and more people in our hotel quarantine. But Peter, if you are planning a trip to Melbourne, the advice remains the same. Think about it again.
Chris, thank you. And from tomorrow, life in New South Wales frees up a little bit more. The cap on numbers for pubs, clubs, restaurants and function centres will be scrapped, replaced with the 1 person per 4 square metre rule. That includes the Star Casino Complex, which will be able to host around 4,000 people in a move which will see around 2,600 or 60% of its staff back at work. Football stadiums can take crowds at 25% of capacity. Restrictions on funerals will be eased with the 4 square metre rule to be applied, but the cap of 20 guests at home and 20 for outside gatherings will remain. July 1 will also mean a slightly easier ride to work for many. Nine's Natalia Cooper joins me from the Wynyard Bus Interchange tonight. Natalia, what can commuters expect?
Pete, public transport capacity will be doubled, but passengers will still need to leave a space or a spare seat between themselves and other customers. Transport workers were today adding a whole lot more of those green dots, which show us where we can sit and stand safely. From tomorrow, trains will be able to carry 68 passengers per carriage, a standard bus, 23, that's up from 12, while freshwater ferries can allow 450 people to board. Extra cleaning will still be taking place, and we are being encouraged to travel in off-peak times if we can. Pete?
Natalia, thank you.